गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट द फंडामेंटल राइट, राइट अगेंस्ट एक्सप्लॉयटेशन। इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी आवर नेक्स्ट फंडामेंटल राइट, दैट इज राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ रिलीजन। अकॉर्डिंग टू आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, एवरी वन एंजॉयज द राइट टू फॉलो द रिलीजन ऑफ हिज और हर चॉइस। दिस फ्रीडम इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ hallmark of democracy. Historically, there were rulers and emperors in different parts of the world who did not allow residents or citizens of their countries to enjoy the right to freedom of religion. Persons following a religion different from that of the ruler were either persecuted or forced to convert to the official religion of the rulers. Therefore, democracy has always incorporated the freedom to follow the religion of one's choice as one of its basic principles. The right to freedom of religion is guaranteed to all Indians by the Constitution under Articles 25 to 28. This topic, which is intertwined with the concept of secularism, is very important for Indian context. The Constitution of India guarantees the right to freedom of religion to not only individuals but also religious groups in India. Article 25, first article of right of freedom of religion, freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion, means the freedom of conscience, the freedom to profess, practice and propagate religion to all citizens. In India, everyone is free to choose a religion and practice that religion. Freedom of religion also includes the freedom of conscience. This means that a person may choose any religion or may choose not to follow any religion. Freedom of religion includes the freedom to profess, follow and propagate any religion. Freedom of religion is subject to certain limitations. The government can interfere in religious matters for rooting out certain social evils. For example, in the past, the government has taken steps banning practice like sati, bigamy or human sacrifice. Such restrictions cannot be opposed in the name of interference in the right to freedom of religion. The Constitution does not allow forcible conversion. It only gives us the right to spread information about our right to freedom of religion. Article 26 says freedom to manage religious affairs. The article provides that every religious denomination has the following rights subject to morality, health and public order. The right to form and maintain institutions for religious and charitable intents. The right to manage its own affair in the matter of religion. The right to acquire immovable and movable property. The right to administer such property according to the law. All these are the detailed factors of this article. Right to freedom of religion. Article 27. Freedom to pay taxes for promotion of any particular religion. According to Article 27 of the Constitution, there can be no taxes, the proceeds of which are directly used for the promotion or maintenance of any particular religion or religious denomination. Right to freedom of religion, Article 28 says, freedom to attend religious instructions or worship in certain educational institution. Means this article permits educational institutions that are maintained by religious groups to disseminate religious instructions. This provides that no religious instruction shall be provided in state-run educational institutions. educational institutions administered by the state but that were established under any endowment or trust which requires that religious instructions shall be imparted in such institution is exempt from the above clause that no religious instruction shall be provided. Any person who attends any educational institution recognized by the state or receiving state aid shall not be required to participate in any religious instructions that may be imparted in such institution or also attend any religious worship in such institutions unless he/she has given consent for the same. In the case of minors, the guardians should have given consent for the same. These four articles I explained in detail, right to freedom of religion. Being a country which is home to several religions, it is necessary that the government must extend treatment to different religions. Negatively, it means that government will not favor any particular religion. India does not have any official religion. We don't have to belong to any particular religion in order to be a prime minister or president or judge or any other public officials. We have also seen that under the right to equality, there is a guarantee that government will not be discriminate in the basis of religion. In giving employment, the institution run by the state will not teach any religion or give religious education, nor will they favor persons of any religion. The objective of these provisions is to sustain and nurture the principle of secularism. And in next slides, we will study about the next fundamental right. Thank you and have a nice day.